Hi guys, it's Angelia. How's everybody doing today? I thought I'd get up here and do me a video and just chat with you guys a little bit. Actually show you a project that I'm working on too. I just got back from town and thought, you know, it's a beautiful day. It's actually probably about 3:30 maybe, getting that time of day, and I thought, you know, I'm going to run out there and I'm going to do a video and show them what I'm working on before I have to do my chores and try to get a walk in before the sun sets. And hopefully I can get through this video without any interruption from Mr. Jekyll. You can hear him already in the background. I actually brought some bread to see if I can entice him into the pen, but he's way over there, and he's already came over a few times and harassed me a little bit. Yeah, he is something else. For those of you that are new, that is my rooster. We live on a little farm here, and I got the meanest rooster. But, yeah, he's something else. But anyway, what am I? And if you hear that noise in the background, that's because hubby's working on some project for his sister. So you're probably going to hear that. But I think he's fixing to leave and go do some work for her. But anyway, I wanted to get up here and show you guys the Christmas project that I have been working on. And as I mentioned before, I'm so excited. I can't wait to get started on some more things. And I got all these things in my head, and I know I'm going to run out of time. I'm not going to have time for all of it. But you know what? Even if it gets past Christmas, it's okay. I'm going to still keep on going. And then, you know, Lord willing, I'll be able to enjoy it next year around Christmas time. And so there's no set time, is there? But anyway, I thought I'd get up here and show you guys what I've been working on. I've been working on it a little bit at a time. You like my project bag? Hey, it works. And no, I'm not sponsored by Walmart. Oh, but anyway, yeah, I got several of these, and so they're pretty good size, and you know, it's a good size for what I'm working on here, so might as well put it to good use. I am making me, well, it's something that I've been wanting to make for a long time, but I've always put it off. And when I do make a blanket, I always put it in my craft room. And but this time I'm finally going to just do it, and hopefully it won't get snagged. And what I'm saying is, I've got cats. I've got three kitty cats in the house, and they have claws, and I've always wanted to make an afghan to put on my couch. I do have one in there, but it's like on the back of a chair in the corner where they don't mess with it. It's just a little wooden chair. But I want to put one on my couch so bad, and so I decided, you know what, I'm just going to do it. And so I got out all my Christmas colored yarn that I like the traditional colors, the red and green and white and blues, you know, and stuff like that. And so that's what I did, and I got it all out and started on it. Now this is a pattern. Let me see if I can, yeah, that one's not attached. I got to attach that white yarn now. But it is a pattern by Jada and Stitches, and I've made a couple of these before. And she calls it the Crochet Chevron Ripple Zigzag Wave Blanket. And it is, she also, it's a, she has a tutorial on it. And she also has a, it free on a blog that I'll put a link down below where you guys can go check it out. And as always, the sun has found me. Hold on. Okay. Hopefully it'll stay behind those trees. I better hurry, huh? But anyway, yeah, she has a, I think it might be a free PDF download if I remember right. But anyway, I'll put links down below where you can go check it out if you want to make you one. And like I said, I've made one, a couple of them before, and I really love it. And here comes my doggy. Between my rooster and my dogs wanting to go behind here and take bathroom breaks. They got all this area here to do that, and they just want to go right here behind mama. That way you guys can see them. But anyway, back to my blanket. I don't think they want me to do a video. Here's how it's turning out. Now, I think I did, I know I did over 200. I did like 230 something maybe chains. And this thing's big. I got it folded actually in half so I could put it on my couch. And I think I might have made it just a little too big, but I don't care. If anything, I can fold it in two and just put it across the middle of the couch, because my couch ain't that big. But anyway, I think it's turning out so pretty, and I just love all these different colors like that. Now, I started off thinking, okay, well, I'm going to do five rows of each color that I chose to put in it. And then when I got about, I think right here to the blue, I thought, you know, I can't do it. I want it to be less than that in some of it too. So I'm not going to stick to the five all the way through. So I just wanted to just, if I wanted to just put one row of one color, that's what I'm going to do, or two or whatever. So that way it can make it even look more scrappy. But I think it's turning out so, so pretty. And of course, I still got all my ends to sew in. And I do cut a long string whenever I go to do my ends, because that way I can weave it back and forth and hopefully it won't come out. But anyway, I'm using a 5mm hook, if I remember right. Got yarn in my mouth there. And the colors that I'm using, I feel like I'm way back. I need to scoot y'all forward. Yeah, that's good. Now, the colors that I'm using, and I've got them all right here in my bag. And this is really a fun blanket to work on, because, you know, once you learn how to do the stitch and everything, it's, you know, you don't even really have to think about it. So I'll just sit there and work on it for a little bit. Now, the colors that I'm putting in it is this Red Heart Super Saver Metallic, and it is white. And it's got like 255 yards in it. And I'm fixing to start this one in it, because I ran out whenever I was doing that row. And then I'm doing the Mainstay Green. And this one's got like almost 400 yards in it. And this is all acrylic. Let's see here. I guess this is, 98% acrylic. And the other percent is two other fibers. I guess it's because of that, that shiny, because it's got a sparkle, a shine to it. It's metallic. And it looks like snow. It's so pretty. And then the other one that I'm putting in it is this one right here. Now, this is that new colorway they just came out. And it's the Red Heart Super Saver Jumbo Speckle. And the colorway is Cherry Speckle. And, of course, whenever I seen this, first thing I thought of was Christmas colors, because it reminded me of my blanket in there that I made that is by Sarah of Repeat Crafter Me, the Christmas lights, which I absolutely love because I love the old-fashioned top lights, and it's got all the same colors in it too. And I thought, boy, it'd be pretty to make one of those blankets, another one, and do the border in it, this right here, because I think I did the border in that I actually have it right here in my bag. I think it's called Mistletoe. We'll see. I'll look here in a minute. But this has got like, 482 yards in it. And, so I got that in it. And then I thought, you know I probably don't have any more of that one yarn. And lo and behold, when I went to digging deep enough, I found some. And this is one that I got at Walmart last year or the year before, when I had it for 75 cents, guys. 75 cents for this big old skein. And I ended up getting me a couple of them. Mistletoe. That's what I did the border in on that Christmas light one. Oh, hold on a second. Well, it's my other dog back there. Hopefully hopefully she won't be taking a bathroom break where you guys can see. She's directly behind me somewhere. But anyway, yeah, this one's called Mistletoe. I think it's so pretty. And I was excited that I found some. But that's what I did my Christmas light blanket, the border in. Tell you what, Jekyll's got me shy here. Got me just wondering if that's him coming out from behind the trees. But that's actually my other dog. And the other colorway that I have in it, now this is the Mainstay Sparkle acrylic yarn. And it's got 251 yards, and this one is called Teal. Now, this one is one of my favorites. I love this one. You can see the sparkle in it. And then, gotta have red. This one's just like the white, except it's got, it's red with the sparkles in it. But I think it's gonna be so pretty once I get it finished. Like I said, I think it's gonna take me forever. because I made it so big, and I can't remember exactly how many chains I did, but I know it's over 200 because I wanted to make sure that I made it big enough for my couch. And I'm hoping that my cats will not get up there and snag it, but I just got to bite the bullet and just say, you know, it is what it is, but I just think it's so pretty. But anyway, I can't wait to get it done and put it back there. I like the way that looks right here. So pretty. And I really love how this one's working up. But I just love a scrappy blanket. And you guys know that's my favorite. Scrappy blankets. It just keeps going and going and going. I actually took it in there and laid it across my bed. And it actually hangs over the side. The same is what my, that one blanket that I'm working on, the fall colored one, the rectangle one, that's also another one of Jada's patterns. And it fits exactly the same way. And I thought, you know, I could just keep going and going and going. If I wanted to, I can just put it across our bed during Christmas time. And who knows, I might do it. And then I'll just make me another one for the couch. Make it, but this time make it smaller, because I'm thinking, you know what, if I'm going to go to, you know, the trouble of making it this big, maybe I should just go ahead and make it big enough for my bed. What do you guys think? It'll take me forever, but I don't care. That's okay. Keeps me busy. But anyway, I can't remember if I already said, but I'm using a 5mm hook. But that's what I've been working on. I got this, and I've got a couple of other projects, but I wanted to get up here and show you guys this. But anyhow, I guess I'm going to hop off here. It's kind of getting later. And hubby, I think, is fixing to leave. And I'm sure he's probably wanting to talk to me real quick before he leaves. But anyway, I want to get up here and just chat a little bit with you guys and show you what I've been working on. Yeah, I just got back a while ago. I had to run to Walmart and pick up a few things. And we're going out of town tomorrow. And what we're having to drive tomorrow is not big enough for us to go to a Walmart and do what and get a lot that what we need, because it don't have the back seat in it, because it was the person that he got it from was turning it into like a hot rod, and so he wanted to make it lighter weight, and so he took the back seat out. There's a back seat somewhere. It's at his friend's house. So there's no back seat, so you could pack a bunch of stuff in there, but it just makes it hard to get in and out whenever you have to put the back the seat up to get in and out of it and everything. But it is a lot of fun to drive, and yeah, he really likes that car. But anyhow, I guess I'm gonna hop off here before my dogs do something that I might have to bleep out. I know they're just dogs. Like I said, they got all this land and everything. They want to go right back here just to go to the bathroom. Anyway, I guess I'm gonna hop off here and go see what hubby's fixing to do, which I know what he's going to do, see what he's got to say. And I guess I'll do my chores. But anyway, I hope you guys all have a wonderful, blessed day, and I'll be chatting to you guys real soon.